Hello and welcome to another audio analysis. In today's video, we take a look at the track Show Me How by the American rock band Foo Fighters. This is the third song to be released from their upcoming 11th studio album, But Here We Are. We've already got to hear Rescued and Under You, and we're certainly seeing the band channel a very early sound with these tracks that we have heard so far. And it's something they stated what they wanted to do with this album. They really wanted to channel that mid-90s naivety that the band actually had when they were releasing their debut record and some of the other records they released in the 90s, but show that maturity and that development the band have gone through over almost the past 30 years. Typically, in a new album, the band would use their previous as a source of inspiration to really decide what direction they were going. Unfortunately, that has been brought to a bit of an end due to the passing of Taylor Hawkins, and we actually see Dave Grohl taking back to the drum kit for the first time since The Colour and the Shape. And that change up in sound really has reflected through the first two tracks we have heard, really seeing the band explore their history, really go back to their roots, to the thing that really got them started, and kind of show that matured sound from there. So will this latest track show us how the band have evolved or be stuck in the Stone Age? Let's take a look at exactly how it sounds. So already with this track, I love how Violet is actually contributing, that is Dave's daughter, really working in tandem, the two of them together on this track. And it's quite interesting because it is a very reflective track. You can see that from the start, where have you gone, walking in circles, this idea of the cycle, going back to square one, going back to the band's roots. And this is the much more somber of the three tracks we have heard so far. Made It Through Yesterday, so showing that progression as well. And I like the fact that he's included Violet in this, because already we've got two different ways this track can go. It can be that reflection of the band's career, of their history, and the passing of Taylor, and how that's kind of thinking about that journey that they went on with him. But because we've got Violet and Dave working on this together, it's almost like that bond between father and daughter, or between just a younger person and an older person. The idea of this development, and certainly having this father figure in your life, where does the time go? Watching your child grow up, you can really see that being brought in. I wrote you a melody, rolling your eyes, almost like that rebellious teenage phase, that oh come on sort of thing that's coming through. And I quite like how already we've got these two different paths you can take from this track. And I like the chorus is really reflecting this idea as well. Where are you now? So really you can just see both sides being touched on further here. This idea of reflecting on where are you at now, Taylor? You sort of ascended to heaven, or wherever your beliefs are. Who will show me how? So they were so close that you can really see that emotive side coming through. And I do think having Violet's softer vocals really do help to add that slightly more emotive feel. Whilst Dave can do that, he has this slightly more gravelly voice. So really it's hard for him to show that emotion as strongly as she does by adding that almost soothing lullishness to this track. But it also again highlights that idea of father and daughter. If you've got a young child, where someone loses a parent at a young age, where are you now? Who will show me how to walk through life? Who will guide me almost? So really has this idea being brought through of having someone in your life that likes to guide you, and they pass on, you have to kind of learn to live without them. like how it doesn't have this completely super sullen, too sad tone. I like that way they've got a little bit of pace to it to really just give it a bit more strength. I think it avoids going into that really depressing sound and keeps it quite jolly, like you are wanting to be very reflective. You're reflecting on the good times, not focusing on the bad. I love this idea of wait for the sun. Also, you're going through that darkness when you lose somebody, but you wait for the sun. It will come. It will take time for that wound to almost heal and be to kind of really see the light again almost. But I really quite like that. And this idea of the hummingbirds kind of like coming with the dawn as well of the sun. So really just like life will come back and it will start to spring up again after the dark times have come. And do you have a minute for me? So almost like that minute of silence, that minute of reflection once somebody has gone. So you can really see the reflection coming through on this track. Just every single lyric really points in that direction. I really like this lyric as well, I'll take care of everything, because it can show in lots of different ways. Obviously, with the passing of Taylor, Dave really helped to support his family and everything that he did with this record. He's the one that stepped onto the drums, despite them announcing Josh Freese as kind of being their touring drummer for this album. It was Dave that did actually work on the drum tracking, so he's kind of stepped into those shoes. And now that Taylor's not there to show him how, he's kind of got to revert back to doing it himself, but he's taking care of everything. He's really showing that in Taylor's absence, everything is still okay. It will still keep rolling. They'll still keep honoring him, which they will do probably almost every single show, considering how much of an integral part of the band he actually was. But also this idea of when you lose a parent or something like that, you kind of have to take care of their belongings and kind of keep their memory on. So you take care of everything that they were in control of almost. So again, keeping these two ambiguous sides that you can really reflect on with this track. Okay, so there's one thing I really love they did in the outro. Dave dropped the vocals and it just became Violet, and it shows this idea of kind of having to live on without somebody. The idea that he's been kind of almost with Violet throughout the entire track, and then he drops away at the end and she has to then take care of everything. So really showing that bond between two people that eventually is broken and one person has to continue without the other. So it really does show the idea of parent-child relationships. It shows the relationship between friends, certainly between Taylor and and Dave. So really two strong messages that come through on this track, and I love the beautiful way that they actually ended the track. Just a really strong high note, such a simple little thing to do that really adds a lot of power to this track and really adds a lot of messaging. And I love how musically they don't have to do anything extreme. You've got two beautiful vocals really working in harmony, really just driving the song along. You give it a little bit of pace behind it and that's all it needs. It's an emotive track that has a slightly more upbeat feel despite the kind of sadder messaging that is included, and I really do like that mix. I like that they didn't slow it down so much that it became a little bit almost too of a depressive track. It's more of a celebration of continuing on somebody's legacy, which I really, really did like. So that will be everything for today's video, but as always, feel free to let me know your thoughts about this track in the comments section. Well, I'm certainly very excited for this new album. Interesting to see them going back to their early day sounds, going back to their roots, and really having a bit of a reflective album, which is completely understandable after what the band have been through over the past couple of years. I would be surprised if they didn't do something like this. And we're getting an interesting mix of styles with this more somber sound on this track, but a couple of other tracks that have really had that slightly more almost grungy influence sound to them. Also, if you would like to see more content like this, then please do feel free to subscribe, and I will see you in the next Audio Analysis.